Hey! Sir butts a lot. You gonna go sleep now?
Tickle!
You wanna tickle?
Yeah.
You asked for a tickle. You don't want one now?
No.
Hey, I love you.
Star bought to come.
Okay.
Starbucks.com.
Starbucks.com. Let's get the traction machine. Alexa, what time is it? Never mind, I know.
It's 7:42 p.m.
Yippee! It's December 2019. Let's make a calendar.
Ready? 12! Sunday.
Sunday.
Monday.
Monday.
Tuesday.
Wednesday. Thursday. Friday. Saturday. It's Thursday.
It is Thursday. Move your head. You got some stuff on your head.
It says...
And also, I tend to speculate that unless there's generally
today is Thursday, December 12th,
2019. Today, we're going to be talking about the English James Doe case, known as Moon in the Nettles. As I always say, whenever I cover a Doe case, I believe that these are.
Fill in the missing day. And
these
date.
Have the chance of being solved, a real imminent chance. More people need to know and talk about them.
Thursday.
After we begin,
12.
Friday the 20th.
Great job.
Around 8 a.m. in North Yorkshire, England. Anonymous mails.
That's 31.
He was reportedly a well-spoken man and said that he couldn't give his name for security reasons. He remained on the phone for about a minute, but hung up abruptly when details. This anonymous caller has never been traced. The local village constable follows up on this strange lead and heads to the location, a country road near Second Bank Top between Scorton and Rybo, an area he knows very well, but he doesn't immediately find the body.
3 days!
After carefully searching, he does eventually find her.
3 days.
At first, he
for your calendar.
About 4 to 6 inches long in a pageboy style cut. A toenail was later found buried a couple of inches into the ground, painted pale pink. The position that she was in suggested that someone was in a hurry and had just dumped her. Nearby stable come forward. Said he was riding past in 1979, 2 years earlier, when he noticed a foul smell near the location the body was later found. He didn't investigate it at the time, but please believe that he was likely smelling...
Make a snowman!
O-W, sometimes it sounds like O, as in
snow!
Considering it was just an unnamed country road, it was only a few meters from old...
Snow! Men!
Ten!
Little! Snow! Men!
The fact that Jane Doe wasn't found any earlier than it seems to be just down to pure chance.
Give
the
snow a hat.
This then investigators believe that she was possibly
pick arms for the snow
deer.
This is the first thing that suggested it was a criminal act. Whoever had placed her there had seemingly stripped her of all the clothes
it's
and jewelry.
Cold.
It.
The
may, of course, be poor and
snow man needs a scarf.
Probably meant that she suffered with a lot of back pain.
There!
Her teeth were very gentle as well. She had 4 teeth in her upper jaw and 6 natural teeth in her lower jaw, the staining of which suggested that she was a heavy smoker and likely drank heavily. She was named a tough person who didn't care for themselves very well. Through her teeth, she was able to tell the same dose
of
her
4 help!
An area of high degree of natural
snow! Man,
see, could have been Hartlepool or Grimsby, or she may, of course, come from further afield. Her cause of death was never established, she was just too decomposed. But her skull wasn't damaged, and there were no wounds of any of the bones. Which suggests that it probably was or
help.
The larynx was removed by animals, so
snow, man,
the police
smell.
Also 3 sets of recent tracks leading to the body. Which led them to conclude that the tracks were made by somebody who was looking for this body, potentially this anonymous man who made the phone call. All police in the area got involved, the public were interviewed, there were multiple public pleas for help, and hundreds of people were interviewed to see if any match could have been made. Some children might have had missed visits from the mother.
There he goes.
The public was asked if they knew any woman who had
seen one little, two little, three little snowmen, 4 little, 5 little, 6 little snowmen, 7 little, 8 little, 9 little snowmen, 10 snowmen.
Learning to read. There was a line of inquiry that focused on a female prisoner who failed in reading. She had escaped from nearby Arsenal Crest prison about 2 years earlier. But that led to dead end, as the prisoner unexpectedly responded to a request to prove that she was still alive. She said investigators a signature and she chewed gum fish. Yeah. in a local from North Yorkshire area, but it's worth a shot. And let me bring up the second name of Rocky Mountain.
He's super cool.
I gotta do Avery real quick.
Can you pause it?
It's your cemetery.
Oh, 2%.
Oh, wait. You did not. Happy Quicker Wolf.
Happy Quicker Wolf.
In different
areas, the Yorkshire, his wife's newspaper passed the case when it wasn't found. In 1983, the court opened the case. The case is called Alexa Lemon's Day, though, is finally made to rest in the Cape of Jane's inscription, and the name on the orders 28 Martin. Well done! Okay, six.
What?
In 2012, James was well done. It's great. That's right, Bernie. It's now. Wait, what's the sound? What a terror, terror, terror.
February 2nd is Groundhog Day. February
2019. Then we Saturday. It's Saturday.
Hey guys.
February.
Now I'm going to put my hands up and admit that I have never heard of the Atlanta child murders before my until season 2 aired on Netflix. Even the biggest true crime detective
make a gingerbread boy or girl.
Learn as much as I can. Now this is
boy, girl, triangle. Fear.
So this is one of those weird cases where it's a solved slash not solved kind of
circle.
And the Atlanta child murders are sometimes referred to as just the Atlanta murders. A series of murders that did Atlanta children between July and 19.
Brown. Blue.
At least 20
brown.
Adults were killed and attributed to the same murderer.
Pink.
The victims were young.
Yellow.
Just earlier this year, Atlanta police
brown. Run, run, jump and twirl, catch.
Before I get into the specifics of this case, I need to set the scene a little bit.
Run, run, jump and twirl. You can't catch me, I'm the gingerbread girl.
So this is happening in the late 70s / early 80s in Atlanta, Georgia. The city which had recently grown to be an economic powerhouse in the South. The number of new companies set up shop there.
It's the 100th day of school. Let's count to 100.
A decade earlier, and the Civil Rights Act of 1964 that outlawed segregation in schools, public places, and jobs, there was an increasing black population in the city.
Why? 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9,
10.
Vanished overnight. Now they had a black mayor and there were more black people in the city. Even in one of the more progressive cities in the south, civil rights.
10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90.
Tristan, turn the volume down.
100.
Can you turn it down, please? It's time for Critical Role.
Yay!
You can just turn it to 50%.
Oh, that's four more you get tonight.